There's this preparation part, though, that's so important, right? So for me and Stephen and the Sweetwater team, we were here yesterday making sure that everything was set up and patched and properly working so that when the guys came in today to sound check, you know, we're prepared for them. And so I want to take a few minutes and just talk about how there's a difference in the way we prepare between line check, sound check, and rehearsal. I think too many times we don't delineate the specifics of those three processes, and they are distinctly different. And so line check for us is basically just the simple patching and plugging in of everything. And so that's what we did yesterday. We made sure that everything was properly patched, showing up in the right place in the console, patched into the right inputs on stage, that everything was buzz-free and hum-free, and that we could sort of know that when everybody sat down behind their instrument, their stuff would work. And so then we move from that part of the process, and that can happen without the band in the room. So for those of you who don't do that before anybody's there, I think it's really important to sort of ratchet back the timetable to a point where you have the margin to do that. Because that way, when the band walks in, you can actually greet them. What a novel concept. You know, part of this conversation this week is about how we build a bridge between the booth and the stage. I think actually not being at the booth when they get on the stage is a great way to do that.
That's good.
You know, be there to say hi. Be there, you know, care enough about them and they care enough about you that you know what's going on in their lives. Hey, Matt, I know you and your wife were going to look at a new house this week. How'd that go?
Yeah.
Or, man, your kid was sick. I saw they were out of school. Are they feeling better? We've been praying for you. You know, just simple things to engage like that, to go, you know, we're for each other in this process. So then once the line check part is done, the band's here, then we'll start what we would call sound check. And so to do that, we'll basically, it's interesting because this week we're starting with a new monitor system that none of us have used before and a new console that I've never used before. And so there was a lot of things that were unusual for us this week. So we had to spend more time than we normally would in the sound check process, which was a great exercise, I think, for us, because it challenged kind of the way we think about this stuff. So this morning, before you got here, we started with, you know, typically what most people do. Okay, kick, 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 and the guys are dialing up in their personal monitors. So as a side note, this event is sponsored in part by Digital Audio Labs that has the Live Mix system. And so that's what we're using for our in-ear monitors. So we don't have a monitor console that's dedicated for monitors this time. We don't have a monitor engineer. Each of the people on stage is their own monitor mixer. How many people use a personal monitoring system? So that's quite a few. So for those of you who aren't familiar with Live Mix or have questions about it, those guys are here. Luke is here with Live Mix and Digital Audio Labs, and you need to get your hands on this because it's really impressive. It really works great.